Hit the rock. You see?
In the middle of nowhere.
6 a.m. Wow.
Let the journey begin. Wow.
Oh my God. This could have been, I could have possibly injured myself. My bacon.
Yeah. This is the path to freedom.
So this guy will let his supervisor know that I got stuck over there. So basically I hit the rock. The rock was in the middle of the road. It was as I was turning, and I turned and then there is a rock, and granted I was also text messaging. But usually I react quicker. So we live and learn that in the forest you have to pay more attention. It was one of the volcanic rocks. But thankfully nothing bad happened. And thankfully there is this. There is no service here. And my car is over there. So right now we'll be seeing what is the possibility. Thankfully it happened where the construction takes place, and also thankfully it was me, because otherwise it could have hurt somebody else, the rock being in the middle. I'm ready to sacrifice myself for something like that. And this is how it looks, you see. Yeah, I think usually here. Road. This is how far we go. It so happens that my spare tire that I never used, it's kind of working. So we're driving. There is the next service is about 1.5 miles away. Like there is no way to go. And it just worked out with all this stuff in the car. I'm so grateful. I'm so grateful. And I had so many thoughts in that moment, and I just surrendered and things just worked out. And thankfully it was me. Thankfully it was me who had to sacrifice breaking a tire and rim and all that stuff. But I'm just grateful. You know, I'm just grateful. And immediately I thought, okay, now I have to go someplace else. I'm not driving to the dental appointment. I'm driving someplace else. So, and I have to drive no more than 50 miles an hour. So that's the reality. Anyways, I'm sending you so much love. I'm very grateful for everything that taking place. Just grateful. That's all. Reality is such that we have to be grateful for everything that happens. This experience really made me more introspective in terms of why this had to happen to me, blah blah blah. But I have a feeling that there was this conversation between our friends, is that someone has to sacrifice sometimes, and I I can imagine if this happened to someone else, it'll be too much stress. It'll be a crazy amount of anxiety when you drive on a rock at the turn. So I'm happy it happened really to myself. It really tested myself in the environment, in the element. Pretty much showcasing what I'm made of, what it is in me that can withstand such experiences, and also be grateful for this. This happened. Thankfully, it did not rain as much. It was a very strong rain, so it allowed me to really. Be grateful for that moment, because it could have been worse. And the workers just started working. It was 6 something a.m. and they just started to work. So there was somebody else, there was no service, there was no connection really to call anybody. And I was like, well, whatever happens, happens. And I just started cleaning my car, and thankfully the spare tire was there, which I never used. And I learned something new, that I have a working spare tire apparently. Now I probably have to replace all the 4 wheels, rims, we'll see. I don't know what else has been damaged, but I'm driving, as you can see. So whatever that is, I'm just grateful. I'm just grateful. The energies are intense on many levels. And that's my path to liberation. The path to liberate myself from all the material. That's how it looks. Just so you know. You want to liberate from unnecessary material stuff, you have to take certain steps. So, much love. Everything is good. Doing it. Doing it. And the weather, interestingly, there was a storm before the sign, really stormy, and then thankfully it got, as I escaped it, it got silent. Look at the weather, so beautiful. The guy who worked there, they were just rebuilding the road. He's not a AAA, there was no insurance. Their closest towing was maybe hours away. So it's just calm, self-belief, and acceptance of the reality. Because at the beginning it seemed like I'm middle of nowhere, and there is this only 2 workers there, and I happened to hit the rock, and I happened to push the car far enough intuitively. Because if I didn't push the car far enough, I would not even see these workers. So I had the feeling that after I almost like got into the ditch or whatever, I pushed the car far enough, and that let me see these workers. So no matter what happens, stay calm. Your eternal being, you know, when you understand your eternity, life will become easier, trust me. Eternity, it's this, is eternity, all of this. And all of this stuff in the car is material. I'm gonna get rid of all of it, most of it. Big hugs. She was the meanest cat. My baker. She knew how to die. This is it. Know how to die and be reborn. The thing is, there was another huge accident. Like the car just totaled itself, like no hood, nothing. And it just happened a moment ago after I got on the road. The energies are like, my baker.